Who doesn't know the situation? A seminar at university with this evil, vengeful blackboard sitting there, waiting until a random student has to perform some sort of calculation in front of the whole class. Naturally, this seminar is also attended by you, represented in this video by Rex. Hello, Rex. Thankfully, you don't have to attend the seminar alone. Your friends are also with you. And last but not least, there is Frederick Foxington, the postdoc leading the seminar. He has the power of deciding which poor student has to come in front of the class and risk embarrassing him or herself if the prepared solution is incorrect. This is the basic situation for every seminar at university, but this one is special. You did not have to go to the blackboard the last few times, which increases the possibility of being called out this time. And you also have this strange feeling about the solution to one of your exercises. Exercise 4. Although you have done your homework, your solution to this infamous exercise 4 somehow seems fishy to you. The question in this exercise was if the infinite sum 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 and so on converges, and if so, prove it. You have derived an argument that should be able to at least withstand a minimum of scrutiny. Your solution of minus 1 over 12, however, does somehow seem strange. How can the sum of all natural numbers add up to a number smaller than 1, yet alone a negative number? On the other hand, infinity tends to behave very strangely, and surprising results are, well, not surprising. But let's not panic just yet. Maybe someone else has to present exercise 4. Frederick Foxington starts the infamous exercise 4 by writing the number on the blackboard. Your nervosity increases as Frederick starts to raise his voice. Rex, would you like to show us your solution? Now is the time to panic. Of course he calls you for the one exercise you are not confident presenting. At this point, there are just a few seconds to think of a strategy as you take your homework sheet and make your way to the blackboard. You will try a proof by intimidation. The aim of such a proof is to intimidate the audience with your performance such that no one dares to ask a question. So first, let's get rid of this uncertain look and put on your confident face. Very important to succeed with this kind of proof is that you, of course, have an argument ready that does withstand very minimal levels of scrutiny. If your argument instantly falls apart, we recommend using a classical proof by verbosity. Aside from these prerequisites, it is very important that you seem confident, stay calm, do not under any circumstances seem insecure, do not rush your arguments, and assume confident body language, especially during critical parts of your performance. Before we see how Rex performs his proof by intimidation, let's dive deeper into the psychology behind the high art of this special proofing method. Any random student in the room, represented by Creeping Goat, will be confused during your calculations. If this random student assumes the other students to also be confused, he or she will be tempted to question your arguments. This is why we always use language that implies that everyone in the room knows exactly what we are referring to. We use phrases like, "We all know this equation from analysis 2. Every student is familiar with." And a standard phrase of intimidating uncertain students, "It is trivial that." Be very careful though with that last one, since it can be interpreted as very condescending and prompt Creeping Goat to ask a question. By using these and other similar phrases, Creeping Goat tends to assume that everyone in the room must agree with you, and to avoid the risk of revealing their lack of knowledge in front of the class, will avoid asking questions. Congratulations! You have successfully performed a proof by intimidation. Keep in mind that you will most likely not intimidate Frederick, but from what we saw, this is mostly not necessary. The postdocs are not here to call you out. They tend to not pay too close attention to you calculating, and if no student asks a question, they are most likely fine with your solution. Okay, the strategy is clear. Again, assure that you seem confident and let's start calculating. The first step is to assign the value x to our infinite sum. X equals 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so on. We also create a second equation by multiplying the first one by 4, yielding 4x is 4 plus 8 plus 12 plus 16 and so on. Now we subtract the first equation from the second one, but we shift the terms of the second equation in a creative way. Since the sum is infinite and addition is commutative, everyone knows that this is allowed, you argue confidently. The result is minus 3x equals 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 plus 5, and so on. Look out! Even though you have presented this first fishy step in a very confident and convincing manner, Creeping Goat seems as if they want to start asking a question. You immediately have to intervene by escalating your posture to an especially confident and intimidating stance. Phew! Well done! Creeping Goat does not dare to ask a question about this obviously trivially legal calculation. You continue with the next certainly sound argument. As we all know, the sum 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 and so on is equal to the power series of the function f of c is 1 over 1 plus c squared with c is 1. We are all familiar with the power series of this function, and setting c as 1 in this power series, we arrive at the sum above. This is why we conclude that 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 plus 5 and so on equals 1 over 1 plus 1 squared equals minus 3x. Finally, the last calculations. If minus 3x equals 1 over 4, then x equals minus 1 over 12. Therefore, the infinite sum 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so on equals minus 1 over 12. So far, so good. But now comes the most critical part. Until Frederick sends you back to your place, you must stay in front of your calculations and risk questions of the students. It is especially crucial that you seem confident here and make sure that everyone is sufficiently intimidated. We recommend you assume your confident intimidation pose and optionally, if you have one, use your intimidating war scream. One more. Perfect. After these screams, no one would dare to ask a question. Congratulations, you made it. Or have you? What if, despite your marvelous performance, Creeping Goat still speaks up? Depending on a question, you have two options. Option 1. Double down. If the question is simple to answer and does not address an obvious flaw in your argumentation, then simply answer the question to the best of your knowledge. Assume Creeping Goat is confused about where the fraction 1 over 1 plus 1 squared came from. In this case, you again explain the power series of the function f of c is 1 over 1 plus c squared is equal to 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 and so on, after setting c to 1. That's why we conclude that 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 equals 1 over 1 plus 1 squared equals 1 over 4. The second option is to abort the mission. The question asked by Creeping Goat hits the weak spot of your argument precisely. He asks about the convergence of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and so on. If convergence cannot be proven, then assigning a value to the sum does not make any sense. Truthfully, it is self-evident that the sum does not converge, and your argument is therefore debunked. At this point, you can try to save face by scrambling some equations to the blackboard, but we recommend that you simply admit to being wrong on this one. Thank you so much for watching. We sincerely hope that you enjoyed the video, and maybe we were even able to cast a little smile on your face. Thanks so much, and see you next time.